working out on the bench in the lab. Yeah. Hey, it's Fran in the nuclear lab with the sun shining behind me. It's not ideal. I kind of liked the last setup because I had the windows on that side of the camera as opposed to the behind me. Not a big fan of all the backlighting during the daytime, but yeah, there was this article in the Inquirer about Philly's micro-influencers and a $16 billion industry. There's one of them right here, micro-influencing. I hadn't heard of this term before, micro-influencers, so I was depending on the article to educate me about exactly what micro-influencing might be. It says micro-influencers have more followers than regular people, but fewer than a celebrity, roughly 10,000 to 100,000 followers. Okay, but does that mean if you have more than 10,000 followers that you're a celebrity? That doesn't really jibe. I'm definitely got more than 100,000 followers, but I'm not a celebrity by any stretch of imagination. And I am not even a micro-influencer, because this is an article in the Philadelphia Inquirer, and as part of this article about Philadelphia micro-influencers, they talked about the fact that the Franklin Institute, my old friend, the Franklin Institute, Aaron Armstrong, Vice President of Marketing, Communications, and Digital Media at the Franklin Institute, which recently invited influencers to its Disney 100 premiere. I did not get an invite as an influencer. Not that I would have gone to the thing about Disney. I think it's ridiculous that the Franklin Institute is even entertaining Disney. I mean, what does that have to do with science or STEM or Ben Franklin or anything about the history of, mechanics or electronics in Philadelphia? Nothing. But yeah, apparently I had read another article where they had this big soiree for influencers at the Franklin, and I was like, well, I didn't get an invite. It's official. I am not an influencer, and even the prestigious Franklin Institute does not consider me to be an influencer. And in fact, I'm not even a micro-influencer. So, I don't know. Is it possible to be an influencer when you're, in your 50s or 60s? Maybe that's the thing. Maybe it's not possible to be an influencer at such an accelerated age as mine. Maybe you really do have to be young to be an influencer. If you're old and people follow you, you're just, a curiosity. Tuning into the freak show. So yeah, discuss in the comments. I'm even uncomfortable with the idea of even being considered an influencer, because I don't want to influence anybody. The whole idea of what I do is kind of contrary to the idea of influencing people. If there's any mission to Fran Lab, it is to think for yourself, be open-minded, exercise critical thinking, but don't take things for granted, but really understand data. I don't want to influence people. Maybe you can't be an influencer if you're doing things that are educational or instructional, because maybe there's no influencing to be had. But again, this is like, well, why does an institution like the Franklin put any stake in people who are influencing other people to buy products or to beauty stuff, trends, lifestyle? What would any of that have to do with the Franklin or the Franklin's mission? I don't understand. If you, by definition, cannot be an influencer if you're in the educational and teaching and information side of things, then why are influencers valued at an educational institution? I don't know. I don't get this one. Anyway, I don't want to influence you in your opinion of what it is to be an influencer. I just know that I'm not one. I'm definitely not an influencer. And you can take the Franklin Institute's word for it. I am not an influencer. So thanks for watching. thanks to my patrons who support me not influencing anyone. I wouldn't be able to not influence anyone if it wasn't for my patrons who make all of this completely non-influential content possible. So thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone on Patreon, for allowing me to not influence anyone. I'll be back here, not being an influence at all, real soon.
Berserk in my lab. It's where I work. I'm Fran.